Hello everyone, I'm Lila. Welcome to my dreamland. I love Solidworks modeling. One day I was practicing by myself, an idea came to me. Why not study with others who also love modeling? That is the reason I opened this channel. Let's play with Solidworks together. Today we're gonna make a stethoscope. The stethoscope has four parts. We're gonna make the four parts separately and then assemble them together. First, we make the head part. Open a file in inches, part 5 in inches, and save the file. Name it stethoscope head. Stethoscope head, save. Now select the front plate and make a revolve base. We draw a center line first and then use the line. Okay, now give the smart dimension. This is 1.25. Oops. This is 0.8. This is 2. Okay, skip it. And now we're gonna make the height. The height from here to here is 0.15. From here to the base is 0.65, and the total height is 1.25. Now we fully define this sketch. Just escape the sketch to the revolve. Okay, now get the basically what the head part look like. Now do a revolve cut in the top part. We select the front plate again. Do revolve cut. We need to draw a triangle here. Use the midpoint of these two lines and connect like this. So the angle of this is 14 degrees. Okay, now I fully define this and select the axis. You can see the preview is like this. Now I need to do the other extrude base from the right plane. We need a center line again. Draw a center line first. Two circle have the same center point. And I give them the dimension. Smaller one is 0.23. The bigger one is 0.25. And the center to the base, center to the base is 0.35. Okay. Now from here we clear this and we're gonna select it by ourselves. Depth is 1 inch. We're gonna use this sketch again, so show this sketch. Select the sketch and extrude the base. Still here, we clean this. And I select the center one. Here, from, we change to surface or first plane, or face plane. Select this face. And height of this depth is 0.25. Okay, now hide this sketch. I'll give them some fillet. 0.05. Hey, see? We got it. Change the color. Add the color to white. Okay, nice. Save. Now we make the second part tubing. Open a new part 5 in inches. Select the front plane, make a sketch. draw the center line first. Okay, escape. And now I'm going to draw two lines. Escape, select line, draw another one. Escape. Okay, now make the two line symmetric with the center line. When you select all of them, just select the first one and hold control and then select the other two. So you can select all of them. And then, for example, we select this one and hold control, select this one, we end another relation is equal. Okay. Make these two points in this horizontal, and another relation is horizontal like this. Okay. They should be in the same line. And we select the tangent arc. Tangent arc. Make like this, escape. And select the arc, control, and the center original point. Make it the midpoint. Give the smart dimension. The radius is 1.5. And the height of this is 1 inch. Okay, now we fully define this. Just escape the sketch. And then rename it. Slowly click this place twice. Then you can change the name. Change this to the pass 1. Now we click the top plane and the reference geometry, select the plane. And the distance from is 2.5. Make sure the new plane is on the top of the top plane, like this. Okay. Now we select the plane and make a sketch. We draw a circle here. Give the dimension. The diameter of this circle is 0.3 inch. And then escape the dimension. And then rotate the whole thing a little bit. And then select the center, hold control, select the pass profile, and then select the pierce. Okay. Now see the circle is black. This means we fully define this. And the escape. And the slowly click this twice. Now your name this is profile. Profile 1. Okay. Now use the swipe both. The pass the profile 1 and the pass 1 like this. Okay. Done. Hide this plane. Now we select the front plane again, make another sketch. From the use line, from the original point, draw a vertical line like this, and then the tangent arc. See here? This means the arc is 180 degrees, which is the we want it. So click here, and I select another line here. This means this line is vertical and the tangent with the arc, so we want it. Click, and then give the dimension. Height of this is 5 inches, and the radius of this is 2 inches, and the height of this is 1 inch. Okay, now we fully define this, escape the sketch. This is our slowly click twice, and then we can rename this is pass two, and then select the top plane sketch. On the top plane, we draw a circle and give the dimension is 0.3 inch. Escape. Oh no, no escape. Edit the sketch. We need to do the piercing thing. So select the center and hold the control. Select this line and the pierce. Okay. Now the sketch 4, we click twice slowly and change to profile 2. Now do another sweep. this time this is the profile 2, pass 2. Okay, almost done. Click this face and the extrude card. Extrude card. Make a circle. Here, you just put the little pen sign on the edge of the circle. You can see a midpoint here. So just click here, the center point here, and draw a circle like this. Okay, now move to here, try again. Click the edge, see the center point, and click the center point, draw another small circle. Okay, now just select. We just select this circle, hold control, select another one, make them equal. Okay. Now give them the dimension. Dimension is 0.23. Fully defined, escape the sketch. Now we do the cut. Cut the depth is 0.25. We do another one on this face. Select this face and the extrude card. Draw a circle here. Select this edge. See the center point. Click the center point. Draw a small circle and give the dimension. It's 0.23. Okay. Fully defined. Escape. The depth is 0.25. Okay. Okay. Ta-da! We got the tubing. Okay, I can make it look. Control 7. Okay, this is the isometric view. I change the color. Make the color the same. Make the color white. Okay. Now save this. The name is Stethoscope Tubing. Okay, save. Now we make the third part. Open another part 5 in inches. Select the front plate and make a revolve. Draw the center line first. Select the line. And the 3-point arc. Okay, and the smart dimension here to here. This dimension is 0.2. From here to here, 0.27. Length of this is 0.35. And the radius of the arc is 0.3. Okay, now we fully define this. Escape the sketch. The axis is the x-axis. You move like this. This is the earpiece part. Okay, we make a hole here. Don't use the hole wizard. So select the hole wizard and normal too. And now we're gonna use this counter bore, and make sure this is the NC inch, like your profile settings, and we select this is the hex screw, and click select here, show customer sizing. We're gonna change the number here, so this one is 0.1, make this one 0.1 inch, and this one is 0.23, like this, and this one, the depth is 0.15, and the end condition through all. Okay, now we click the position here, make the position from the original. Right click and the left click. Okay, we can see this section view. Click, you can see inside the hole we made is like this. Okay, escape. Now we save this. Name of this is earpiece. change the color. Color to white. Okay. So now let's make the fourth part, the mantle tube. Open on another part file in inches. Select the front plane and make a sketch. Use the line. Draw a vertical line like this, and left click. Select the tangent arc. From this point, draw a tangent arc. See, this time we want the angle of the arc is 90 degrees, so click here. And left click, select line. Draw another line. This means the line is tangent with the arc and the horizontal. Now give them the dimension. The height of this is 3.25 inches. And the radius is 0.75. And the length of this is 0.5. Okay, now we fully define this. Just exit the sketch and slowly click twice. Change the name to pass. Click the left click the top plane and make another sketch. The circle. Give the dimension. 0.23. Okay. Select, rotate a little bit, select the center, hold the control, select this line, and pierce. Okay. Now escape. Slowly click twice, and change the name to profile. And the sweep. This is the profile. This is the pass. Okay. Now change the color to white. You can change to any color you like. Okay, now save this. This is the Stethoscope mantle tube. Save. Okay. Now we have the four parts for the Stethoscope already. So we're gonna do the assembly together next time. Thank you for watching. If you have ideas and advice, just let me know. Thank you very much. See you next time.